Whoa! We are back.
Yo.
Man, so Steve just showed physical violence.
Why?
It's like, if you didn't stop that playback, I'm gonna punch everybody in the studio. And the only person in here is me and him. So I don't know why you're talking about studio. Just me and you.
Yeah, but now, what do you want to hear?
Yes!
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
But
even now when I'm getting ready to go somewhere.
Yeah, this is side two of the record.
I'm listening to this shit.
He's got a good voice.
He does, man. Listen to this.
The guitar work is excellent.
Absolutely. The band is immaculately, like, they're tight, dude. Through all the whole album.
Oh yeah.
I just had to like this song the most.
Well, when I was in the Navy, this guy had a couple records before this, but yeah.
Scott Darling, look this song up. That's my buddy from Wilmington. You guys had a farm, Ramos Farms. So.
Now, Wilmington, North Carolina?
Yes.
North Carolina.
Yeah, on the coast.
Right.
They have a coastal farm.
On the East Coast.
Yes. So.
Well, not Wilmington.
No. We're talking on the coastal region of North Carolina. Yes. And Scotty Darling? Yes. Look this up, bud. Is he he's the one that I told you in Dark Cherry where I had to go for whatever. And he would ask me, Eddie, what is this song? And I would listen to it on his earphones.
Yeah.
And I would tell him, and you know what? This cat would write it down. I'm like, man, look up our show. And he was the first subscriber I had when I got out, like, instantly. So he got out a month before I did.
He was like you to me.
Yep.
He was like, you know, it was a song to him.
He was learning. And he was like, Eddie, what is this? And I would name who it was. You know, like, you can listen to classic rock up there where the area was, so, and he's like, you know, 2 hours away, whatever. I'm 3-4 hours away. And he was like, Eddie, what is that? And I would name it, you know. And then, it was cool. Me and he were good friends, you know. Like, he was a hush or whatever, but.
What's that one show we have to do? Those pop on the cover of Rolling Stone Magazine years ago. Those brothers, I never heard of them.
Oh, yeah,
who was on the cover of Rolling Stones a few years ago?
Oh, probably the Jonas Brothers.
Yes, I never heard those,
I haven't either, Steve, but they're like modern pop. You know better.
You think I like them?
Loaded. No. Did I say you like them?
I don't know.
What are you talking about?
I've never heard
You're
that.
You're talking out your ass now.
No,
the only reason I know him is Carmen.
I've never heard that Jonas Brothers.
Exactly, we don't follow modern pop.
Okay.
We wouldn't know half of anything. You don't even know. Right. Now there's like quadruple the amount of artists. Okay. We're so far behind that ain't even funny. Give me a break.
Well, scratch that
idea. I'm just saying, we will try to be ahead, but I'm like mid-90s rock right now. And maybe some mid-2000s, that's it. Actually, some modern Kings of Leon, something like that. Weezer.
Kings of Leon.
Weezer, Kings of Leon.
How about we talk about Kings of Leon? That's a band I'm trying to talk about.
I love them.
Not the Jonas Brothers. It was Kings of Leon.
Oh, yes.
I've never heard of them. But you know, Tom Rant and Raven.
Oh, yes.
We got to get one of their records.
Yes, man. Arizona's a good
that's
record.
What I'm trying,
anything.
Yeah, well, let's find that.
Yeah.
We're going to have a big top letter.
Yeah, man. We need to do that, dude. Yeah. Yeah.
Kings of Leon.
Because you know what? Chris has their channel loaded on his Sirius Radio.
Yeah.
To where it's nothing but their albums.
Okay.
So if he. I mean, I give props to what Chris likes.
Yeah, man.
You know what I'm saying? So.
Yeah.
And they're good. Arizona to like anything.
No, I really don't know obviously.
Yeah, you're not exposed. But I'll tell you what, there are these
Kings
three. It's almost like a Leon Hems.
Well, head. I know, but for a few years, every now and then I'll cover Rolling Stone, Kings of Leon.
Yeah. It's almost as if Leon Russell had two other brothers.
Right, yeah.
Seriously, I'm telling you. And they rocked out. Like one sang like a Leon Hems.
Yeah.
Even, you know, so. They're good. They're from Georgia. It's cousins and brothers, whatever. So, and they were good, man. They're still good. They still make great music. They didn't sell out nothing. When interviewed in one of the Rolling Stone prestigious interviews,
right.
What was the what was the main ingredient that helped you guys when you guys were recording, like Arizona, for instance, that album? Or even the mainstream Sex on Fire, or you know, Use Somebody, whatever. And you know what he said?
What?
The band that marinated to what they wanted, and I had drank to the point that I was getting basically being drunk, and it's live, it's costing money, boom, let's do it. And he would, and by God, they did it. But that was his answer. Chris showed me that one, so yeah, I give him props, dude. Yeah, I love him. That's great.
Well,
you can't beat that, man.
Well, you don't have to be old to be wise.
Exactly.
But what you're saying is about, get ready, let's do it.
Yeah, let's do it, man. You do what you gotta do, let me do what I'm gonna do. Let's get together, we're professional on top of that, so. Exactly. We might go to the brink, but nobody's gonna fall out.
Right.
Exactly. Yeah, man. Yeah, exactly like that.
Yeah. I just can't wait to get football.
I know, man. Yes. By the way, I've had to endure the last 2 days of... One of them was a meme of these two little kids walking into the room. The older brother shuts the door behind the other one.
Right.
And it's like Ezekiel Elliott shut the door on Dak Prescott.
Oh,
like, you can't go to the playoffs.
Yeah,
so there's no type of memes because I'm a Cowboy fan. Yes, we're done, but give me a break. Come on. We had a good season.
Yeah.
So I've endured a lot, Steve.
Oh, yeah.
By the way, I do remember we heard beep, 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 F.
No,
it's not exactly like we're fans of them anyway. Come on.
Yeah,
exactly. We're not.
Whoa.
But if they're gonna whip your ass, I'm all for them.
Oh yeah.
I hate to say it. You're roll my tide, so to speak.
Oh yeah.
You don't have to be old to be here.
Yeah.
Me.
So what does a new year bring for you, Eddie?
A lot of unanswered questions in the beginning because I go, long story short, you know the truth, I go to court on the 14th.
Yeah.
I think something might be extended since not so.
Yeah.
Other than that, a lot of work, actually.
Yeah.
Miss White bought a new home, and we set up shop with our tools, our lumber, our exit stuff, all our stuff we need to tear out walls, blah, blah, blah. We get it going, and she's ready for us to do our thing. We still got plans to do the other one, and she said, that's not y'all's money. She made no point. Look, darling, that's not, the other house is not your money maker. This is where it's at. This is where the work's at, darling. Gets my drip. Yes, ma'am. We'll let that dry. We'll get that looking back over here. Hey, no bones about it, bro. And then hey, when I'm ready to do my car washing thing, when it's cool, let me go. Yeah, so it's all good.
She's cool.
By the way, which
is aunt. I met her and then, she's a
which is Fitzgerald's aunt, which is crazy.
I'm gonna take a break right quick.
Yeah, after these messages, bye.
Oh, I know.
Somebody's
car wash or...
Yeah. Stinson right. And Rollis.
There you go. Yep.
Yes, I had to get it correct.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, by the way, call us if you need a detail.
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
Do it.